versus PSG LGD, and some kind of different heroes coming out, especially towards the end, nothing to say, bringing in the mid Lina.
Like, Lina, I've seen this hero fail so many times. Recently, I've seen the better performances, you know, from Lina in general, but I can understand why, you know.
Look at this!
Stun!
Coming in already with the stuns onto Ice, but Ice and Crit, they're going to turn, and they're going to be actually able to once fight first, but they'll turn over as well towards Y. They'll take down two. As Ice, he's able to live, he's able to get out of there. As PSGLG, they try and look for action. They've got a lot of stuns, but it wasn't enough. And, you know, down the line, it will give, well, we'll see around 4 minute runes. Actually going to have Crit coming in, nothing to say. And down the Light Striker 8. But he's got a run. I bet we'll turn with Crit over towards Jinkyu instead.
Another orb.
He's gonna let's dive for it. Abed, nicely done. Coming in under the tower, he's able to nuke down.
Oh, region rune. Y will pick it up. So that's a big deal, you know, just denying that rune from Puck. Puck is still level 5, like they might be able to get this kill. Yeah, he looks pretty dead.
Hey, may have got the rune, but he's gonna pay off his life. Two kills for Abed. Some beautiful moves from Crit.
This is one of the reasons why EG just decided to go for this like heavy lane pressure. They knew that Razor's gonna have a good time. He is the lane dominator. Same goes for Viper. Mid lane doing really good. Like, Lina, you know, has more CS, but they managed to kill two supports. Puck is level 6. There's the rotation.
I mean, they're just playing around with nothing to say. He'll drop the Laguna onto Fly. They do have the stun as well to finish up the kill. Sleep catches Ice, but it won't catch onto Crit. Jinkyu continuing to close the gap, but Abed is here and does have Dream Coil at the ready. Jinkyu opening things up onto the park. Nothing to say, has the follow-up.
Nice,
the save comes
ball.
In. Crit is going to be able to buy time for Abed to jump out to the side as Abed will escape. They're committing onto Ice will fall, but he brings down Y with him. And Abed with those moves, continuing to go unharmed this game. 4-0-1. Have a refill mid. Maybe seeing if they can make a go here. Arbed's got the Dream Coil. Set things up straight away as they're moving onto the Lina. Crypt's able to dodge the Light Striker Array and the Stomp to stay on top of Nothing to Say. Nothing to Say is trying to bottle up, but the right clicks are too much. As they bring him down, Fly will fall in return as Y turns and runs him down.
Has a lot of damage. That's 200 damage. Puck picks up a DD. Yeah, Y looks pretty there. The Lion.
Jinkyu, maybe Jinkyu can help. Hex out. Into the combo. Shard's actually going to grab the two of them there. Crit, he's going to be able to stop them.
He's going
to
clean them up.
And they just turn and kill them both as well.
Abed, he's on fire. Like, Abed, Puck go brrrr.
Him as much as he's been popping off. The team effort's been perfect. See Fly getting caught out here by Fabiana Jinkyu between the Silence and the X. I'll leave no chance for Fly to dive away. On the bottom lane, Fly and Arbed. Why? We'll put a stop to the movement over. Maybe Arbed would just turn and go for him instead. He will. Dream Coil dropped down. RT as he closes the gap. Y's gone. Now with the jump up to the high ground, they're going to look for more. As they close the gap with the snowball, they'll pick up two. Jinkyu down as well. So deciding not to commit anything else there. RT farming rather deep on his own up top, trying to get this BKB finished. He's going to be found by Jinkyu and Arme. That's easy. I don't know if there's any way.
Can he juke this?
I mean, if he can, that's going to be quite something. He's up in the trees, Arme. He's able to get him just in time before Arteezy escapes. Back over to mid, Arbed. Ice, looking to chase down, nothing to say. Arbed's certainly going to dive in for that one.
It's just so much overtime damage. Witchblade plus anything from Viper. Try to smoke up and possibly get a pick off. They need to be very careful about EG's like Roche taking potential because of Tusk.
He is baiting here as he's got the BKB, he's ready to fight. They do commit on him, but already over to the side. Crit and Hard CC, they'll collapse on nothing to say. They bring down the Lina and now Arbed, Dream Coil, locked down onto Arme. EG will be able to turn and take down both cores as the Arteezy bait works perfectly. He had the BKB, he was more than ready for them to jump as he positions aggressively, and PSG LGD, they fall for it.
He went for the damage style and going into Deso, phase shift attack. Makes a lot of sense. Top lane, Arme getting caught.
Needs a bit of help. The Viper strikes down on him. He's going to drop the Wukong's command. Silence does come in, but he's going to tick very low to the Viper strike. He'll just keep himself alive as now the turnaround's attempted by Faith Bian, moving over to Ice. Jinkyu as well closing in as they bring down both of them and keep Arme
alive. It's so important that he does not die there.
Right. Has to be very careful how he jumps for waves. He's going to come down here. Ice waiting at the side. The Sunray as well,
oh,
this
he killed
a
the
lot
creep.
Of damage as Arme's gone. Fly and Ice ready for him to make that jump. Might even hit the timing to get the chance to start pushing at the
Coil
high ground.
On Lina.
Aggressive jumps, Arbed. He's going to force out that BKB straight away without the Hex and the stun coming out for Jinkyu, but Crit. able to take them away from the stun. Respawn from Ame as Ame TP's over towards the mid. Crit packs out to the side. Extra TP over from Wise. They look to close the gap. Faith Beyond will push back Abed. EG just kiting out these two BKBs for now. Well, they're ready to jump back in. Arteezy. Same with the blink. Abed. Silence out to the two of them. Nothing to say. He's falling low. He's going to use himself. Abed will get burst at once, but he's got the Aegis. He's ready for a second round. Arteezy takes out nothing to say. He's even thinking about chasing into the base for Y. He wants to go past the tier threes, up to the tier fours. He really wants this. Y will pop us out, but Arteezy keeps on diving. Bleach to the side. He's out of there. They won't be able to punish him with three dead on PSG LGD.
The way this fight started, you know, Snowball, PSG, DLGs is like, yeah, they're gonna come into our base, two blinks, they get out of the trouble, BKB's already popped, and then they reset Arteezy.
Ah, mate, he's looking at farm, but they're waiting. Arteezy's ready to go, he pops the BKB, the static link, they're just setting a trap every single time.
Oh, three-man coil.
The three of them, see if they can do more with this EG as they're chasing over. Lightstriker raid down onto Crit, Supernova from the high ground, forcing PSG LGD to run. The shards won't grab anyone, but Arbed, he's still trying to chase off for this. He's up into the high ground. See if they can get any sort of stun landed as he comes out of the face shift.
They can't get him.
Out of there, Arbed. No catch for him.
My finest creation gets out of the trouble.
And EG ready to keep the plays coming. It's Crit. He's got his eyes on nothing to say. They're in with the jump initiation. Punch into the snowball. Nothing to say. We'll punt the BKB, but he's already fallen too low. He'll come down off the back of this Yules to an instant death there. Over to the side. Ame will get the Blue Coast Command out. Ice. Drops the Nether Toxin and the Viper Strike onto Ame. As Arteezy's in with the BKB and the Static Link. Ame's gone. They'll lose to the Lion. Three dead yet again on PSG LGD. Faith Beyond's trying to chase down Fly. But Fly's got backup. Crit jumps in. Over towards the DP. Faith Beyond will be able to turn, take the two of them down, but he'll lose his life for it. Four dead on PSG LGD. And Arbed's not done. He's up to the high ground, chasing down Y, critting as well as they'll force back the ET. Arteezy's in with the slow. It's a team wipe. As EG clean up every single one of them. PSG, LGD all dead. 30 to 10 now.
Definitely this Arteezy Razor, the final pick and the build that he's gone for, that really has just sealed the deal on top of everything else.
Mid lane. Diving in onto nothing to say again, having to put the BKB and running. They do turn, get the Hex, the Light Track Array onto Arbed, but the Eon Disc is good to go. Arbed will be able to jump out to the side. Ame trying to get in on this, but here's Arteezy. Swings around, BKB and Static Link down onto the Monkey King. Ame has got nothing that he can do here as Ame's down yet again. Arbed diving down the rest of them, jumping around over towards Xin Q and Y. Crits him with the punches onto the Elder Titan. Y goes down, Xin Q whipping himself out of the game as Arteezy, he'll help with his whip as well. Four dead once more. It really does feel like there's just nothing to be done, and there isn't. GG is called.
Yeah, I've seen LGD when they're losing the games, they tend to GG out a bit earlier. You know, they feel they do not want to be in this anymore. They do not want this to affect their mentality.
Complete level between him and Faith
Beyond. Yeah, they're playing the bottom lane nicely. They go in, they push the wave, and then they pull it to the side.
Xin Q, he did swashbuckle in on this, so Fly, he's going to build up the Illuminate.
One more hit.
Arteezy spits out the acid spray. And that's going to be a first blood for Artur. That will be three of the four bounty runes here for EG. Bottom lane, Faith Beyond having to continue to hide as he's got no regen. Salve's on the way out.
Arteezy knows
this. He's hunting out. Faith Beyond's looking pretty dead here if they get vision of him. Crit coming over as well as Faith Beyond. He needs help, he needs it now. Xin Q's gonna come over with the swashbuckle. And now Xin Q's also put himself in a bit of a difficult position. Xin Q, he'll also, ooh, is he gonna live? Fly, can he get him? Salve's gonna keep Xin Q alive. So Xin Q able to save himself. Arteezy with the safe
play. Was like super afraid. I guess he did not want to get slowed down. Phase boots will be able to get him. Doesn't even pop the fairy fire, no need.
Xin Q, Arteezy might be able to get him as well.
He has phase boots, he's just gonna run him down.
Here we go, one more punch, boom! Arteezy,
he gets a level 6 from that, drops in a ring of health.
All right.
Oh, he has a chemical rage. Yeah. This was like a tri lane from the start.
I mean, what's happening?
And he's level 6.
Nothing to say. He's trying to get in onto Arbed. We've got Crit and Fly coming in with a rotation. Arbed bottling up. A little too low on the HP to get back in on this. We'll see the TP over from Ice. Does have Ravage good to go if they seize an opportunity to fight. And he's going to pop it straight away. Instantly with a TP in, nothing to say. He was not expecting that at all. I mean, he sees the Tide TPing in. He just stands right on top of it. Ice just presses R and he's gone.
He was like, no way that he's going to use a Ravage on me.
Ice is just like instantly tentacles
out. That was Shift Ravage.
Arbed is swinging around from the side. And already, why? He's been trapped.
came up onto the high ground a little too far. Ice crit, they'll turn towards him. Arbet, in with the simulate, Ravage comes out. Ice tries to save himself. Arbet will be able to pick off Y on the back lines, and that Ravage will stop. Nothing to say from being able to close the gap onto Ice.
They get the kill. Arteezy on the bottom lane, free farming, just needs one extra creep to finish off the battle. This might be the fastest battle. This must be, you know, Noxil's already typing in. Like, let's see if this is it.
He is here, ready to back him up. Not quite having the six on the gyro. Ice, he's got Ravage in a few seconds, so he's happy for them to go. They will, they'll commit here with the Exorcism. Zarbet, he's already been able to take down the PA. We'll see if EG want to try and bring over the rest of them to get a fight going mid. Trying to do their best to push Nothing to Say away from the tower whilst the Exorcism goes to work. Nothing to Say still able to get in, take down the tower. Objective is taken. Ice. Still feeling relatively tanky with the hood, but of course the Exorcism, physical damage still punching through it.
Alchemist, he almost has doubled the net worth at the moment. 14 minutes in, this is just insane.
That's mid. We'll find Ice alone, and with a good angle on the Rolling Thunder, Xing Q will have the lockdown.
He's still not joining, you know, he's just farming, enjoys killing those creeps. Blink Dagger, SNY. Like, they could potentially force a fight inside the pit. There's still a tier 1 tower standing
they're
on the mid lane.
With this blink reveal from Arteezy. They're straight in. And Yules is done. We'll see if they can take that. Nothing to Say on the way down. They can. Ravage popped immediately, leaving no
zoning
chance.
Zoning Ravage. Like, there was...
They're going to start to head up. Maybe see if they can push him back. White. Backed up by Arme. Attempt to start something on to fly. Xing Q. Yeah, he's going to come in with a Rolling Thunder. Oh! Big crit. Comes out from Arme on to fly. I actually caught Arteezy here inside the pit. Jump in from Arme. They're going to be able to find Arteezy. It's a double kill for Arme. They're not done yet.
Yeah,
jump
they will
up,
go
a
back inside
kill.
The pit. Like, he got stuck inside the pit. Usually it's on the cliff, but this time around, inside the pit, like, the minus armor is running, and then go in and take it.
I mean, that's
a baller move.
Exploded out of nowhere. EG were not ready for that. Yeah, Arteezy just going to look to get his farm back on. Get that BKB done before the next fight. Ooh, we are going to have Crit in a bit of a spot of bother here as Arme and Fabian are found in. The backup comes in, but Crit's gone. Arteezy with a two-man concoction, though. Jumps over, gets both of them.
Oh, nice
both
dodge.
Both Fabian and Arme. Arme's down the once. White heading up with the cooldown. See if Arme's able to get any more kills out of this. Turns over towards Arteezy. Jumps in with the dagger. The Phantom Strike. Arteezy silence. Arme gets a second. Two kills here for the PA and PSG LGD. They're not done. They're looking over towards Arme.
He's out of spells. Has the Yule Scepter for himself. Maybe to buy a bit more
with
time.
The damage, Arbet. He's up in the air. One more crit would do it. Arme looking for the kill. He's going to be able to find it here. The Ghost cleaning up Arbet. Fly. He's got to run. Got Ice coming in. Xing Q. The Ravage come out, but the BKB immediately there from Arme. Arme jumps over towards Arteezy. Arteezy commits with the BKB, but the rolls out from Fabian. Looking
where
down
the crits
Arteezy.
At? There
the
they
crit
are.
From Arme takes down Arteezy. Over towards Crit he goes. The BKB from Arme now coming to an end. Arme controlling him with the Remnant. Arme getting low, but he turns. Another crit. Another crit.
He's just
Arme
cleaning
triple
up.
Triple kill. Is flying Arbet, the last two left alive, they've got to run. Arme's going to look to get back in the dagger. Flying over towards Arbet. Arbet over to the tree line with the Dissimilate. The SGLG, they're going to continue to chase. Arbet, what's he got left? Dagger in, horse to the side, missiles on his way over. Arbet, he's going to get stunned.
Give him the Rampage.
Yeah, give him the Godlike.
As we've seen in the previous fight, you know, with the Alchemist and the Tidehunter.
Ice,
he just blinks in.
And Arme's just going to turn straight towards him. We'll be forced to safety by Fly, but Shinkyu's going to come in with Rolling Thunder. Ice still left up on the high ground. The Remnant will grab Arme momentarily. EG, they're considering if they can get in on this. Ice, he's going to pop the Ravage, but he's going to die. EG cannot fight around this. They've got to bail. Full Satanic done on Arme, and of course that dream
They still had one.
Wait,
I have Paladin Sword. All right, he'll take that.
I swear.
Divine Rapier.
I don't know what I was
dropped.
Looking at
them. So, yeah, he needs to get rid of the phase boots. Let's move around the map, pretty much.
They're flying. Here's the smoke up from EG. They're going to walk into a blur. It's going to give the chance for the BKB to come off here from Arme. As Arteezy tries to stay on target. Has to get down from the Rapier, but with the Satanic, Arme, he's back up to full HP. Jumps over towards Ice. The Ravage comes out. The BKB comes through. And Arteezy's in, and he's taken Arme down. Ice perfectly holding the Ravage, ready for the BKB to end. Gets the kill. We'll see Arme getting caught in the combo on the high ground. Roar out onto Arteezy.
Arteezy
needs help. They're in on top of it. Crit comes in with a snowball save. Buyback
from
the turn of Arme. And Ice, they're on their way back over Arteezy. He needs help, and he needs it now, but he goes down. Arme will be able to recover the Rapier. Can he get it back to safety? As he's up in the air, Astral Step ready, and still a Dissimilate.
He has it.
He's got to save it. Arbed's going to get that back to base. As he's running, PSG, they're trying to chase, but Arbed will manage to save the Rapier.
Yeah, two buybacks just to secure that Rapier. Roshan just respawned.
Here we go. Roshan to be taken very, very quickly here by PSG LGD. Is there going to be any chance to get in? There's not crit tries, but Roshan's already gone. Arme just turns towards crit. 1600 damage as crit's gone out of the game. Arme over towards Arteezy. The roar, the crits are there. Arteezy's down as they'll manage to kill him off. Death to 80, and it's over with the Rapier gone. GG is called as game two will be taken by PSG LGD as Arme's PA just pops off.
They know. You know, you said the Arme's Phantom Assassin, yep. You know, this is not a hero that's very exciting until she starts to drop some big crits. This is the rotation that I like to see. Crit, hits level 2, rotates to the mid lane, pull. This should be the first flood.
Yeah, beautifully done.
Did we check the rune?
That's a really good position for Crit to be in. You're not going to expect his positioning at all. They're still going to try and make the move onto Ice turns with a roar onto Faith Bian. And he's going to try for the TP out, but yeah, Faith Bian able to come out as the roar comes to an end and get the roll on. Sitting safely behind, nothing to say. He's inside the jungle. And Xingqiu's going to be caught here by Crit and Fly. They're burning him with the Sunray. He's going to be able to get away with the Shadow Realm.
Oh, he hit him.
The spirits are there. Supernova's out. They're going to try and take down the egg. And they'll just be able to do so. Faith Bian sliding in with some extra hits. And hey, at the end of the day, the 9-minute Battle Fury didn't win the game. So maybe you don't
You're
want
correct.
To, you know, maybe it's sometimes there's too fast. As already, Ice. He's got the catch on the Pango. Follow up from Crit with the Necro book down.
Ahmed just going to go for the same item build. He went on Phantom Assassin. Battle Fury into Deso for some more damage, then into BKB. Ahmed's not the type of a guy that loves second item BKB.
Crit, he's in. Ilz is going to get off, but nothing to say. He's going to go down as soon as he's out of the air. So picking up the Arcane Boots for now, knows that later he's going to be turning it into a Bloodstone. As he's actually going to look for the opening onto White. Damage from Fly. Enough to bring him down. I mean, it does still feel like EG are ramping up at the pace they need to. They're taking these objectives.
He gets the jump.
So if they can get the kill before anything comes in return, they can. Xingqiu doesn't stand a chance. And in fact, over towards the mid crit, he's able to set up onto White.
So EG though gets that Pango rolling.
Rupture onto Pango. Faith Bian is helpless against the damage here from EG. Is there up into the base, double kill for Arbet. It's EG seek a perfect time to strike. The tier 2's down in the mid lane. They may even start knocking up at the high ground.
You know, investing a lot of the gold, so they're thinking maybe he does not have a buyback, but yeah. Faith Bian has a decent amount of farm, even after purchasing that Aghanim Shard.
I mean,
roll up,
base.
It's just so much damage.
We're going to see the attempt here to jump. Arbet's already out with BKP and the zip, he's away. Arme, can he find another target during the duration of the BKB? He can. Over towards the Beastmaster, he goes, jumps in onto Ice. Little bit of a window, though, with no exorcism for a minute. That's mid lane.
They got the
Arme's
jump.
He's going to show. They jump in. If they got the chain locked down, they get the vortex off. They pull him in. Arme's getting low. He's able to put the BKB, turn towards the egg. Arme's able to take the egg off, jump to the side. He's still alive. Zip form from Arme, though. He's looking to finish him off.
Miss.
The evasion. Arme's still up. He's still away, over to the side, he goes to side,
miss.
Stopping the axes from coming up from Ice. But
he gets it.
He's diving in, another jump, Arme still lives, the blood right's laid down in the axes from Ice, finally cut Arme down. There's Arme dead for a minute.
Nah, that miss chance was just way too high, considering how much damage Phantom Assassin does, and they still don't have way of dealing with the evasion other than like Maelstrom, which
GQ
is not that effective.
In the river, he's going to be able to find the setup onto Ice. Crit and Arteezy, they're looking for the counter play. Ice falling low.
Good,
can they keep Ice alive? They can fly with the heals.
So I won't be able to save people with the Terrorize. Like, it's a risky one, you know.
On top crit. He's got the setup here as he's able to find Faith Bian on his way back towards
Roll
the base,
up.
But Faith Bian's got backup. Arme having to pop the cheese as the crits come in from Arme, but Arme, he's been ruptured. Rolling Thunder will hold back Arteezy for now, but they're diving in. The supernova's out. Arme having to pop the BKB, get up to the high ground. Will turn, still having to stand the ground. It's Rupture still in Arteezy. Chasing on, looking towards him.
Arme.
The supernova said he's going to be able to catch him as Arme steps back in range of it. Arme dead for over a minute, and EG, they're not done. They're going over towards Nothing to Say, chasing down the Death Prophet. The Fear will push back the two of them. As well, separating him from Nothing to Say, but RTC ready to zip back in with the movement
Big
speed.
Eight,
Nothing to Say goes down. Y also falls 3 dead on PSG LGD.
Now they're just diving. ET, he buys back, but I don't think they can get any kills out of this.
See Faith Bian trying to jump forward. Arbet, still a bit of mana to play around with. So the roll up, Faith Bian keeps himself safe, but RTZ still pretty much full HP, full mana. And then the life for Ame just gets even harder. See Faith Bian trying to start with the roll in onto RTZ.
Perfectly executed.
Getting the once. Can they go for it a second time? Ame's going to be back in a few seconds. And EG, they will respect that. They get the melee racks and they start to back off, knowing that PSGLGD is going to want to chase. Seems to be a very hard fight for Ame now. As RTZ, he's ready to go. He's found his target, he's gonna start things. Ame jumps over towards the side, but the roar's out. After the BKB, RTZ's in. Has he got enough damage? He's trying to bring down Ame. Can he do so in time for the MKP? He's getting the hits that he can.
Good egg.
Brings down Ame. Ame dead for a minute. Over towards nothing to say. RTZ chases on for the next. As there's two dead on PSGLGD, no buybacks on them. Nothing to say, also taken out. As RTZ cleans them up with a double kill. The mid lane getting pushed in. With three dead on PSGLGD, EG have a huge window to take away multiple racks. PSGLGD, they do at least have the tier 2 down bottom. But now 17k down. I mean, PSGLGD's a little split. Why is Xingqiu and Faith Bian still outside of the base? Faith Bian's been ruptured. RTZ moving in on him. Faith Bian, look at the roller pop it up. It's already been able to pick off Y. An attempt to TP out is made, but Ice puts a stop to it with the roar. Faith Bian will die. PSGLGD down 2 again. And Crit, he's ready to die. See if he can catch more. Looks for Xingqiu. Able to dodge the blood right with the Yule. Xingqiu will live. And again, I mean, PSGLGD are really trying their best to get out and find some sort of a jump, but... no, Faith Bian is going to try and start things. They get the jump in onto RTZ, but the roar comes out onto Ame. Now RTZ with the BKB out, ready to turn. Moves it with the rupture. Ame's gone. Dead for AD. Over to nothing to say. Nothing to say. Buy some time with the Yules. But RTZ moves over towards Faith Bian. RTZ getting stunned for the moment, but now he's ready to continue to fight on. Keeps beating into nothing to say. Takes down the Death Prophet, and now he's diving in towards the fountain. Over he goes towards Y. Y will slowly but surely fall, and maybe not the roots. Holding back RTZ. Y, he's able to live. We'll get back towards the fountain. RTZ's going to look to try and dive in onto nothing to say.
They just don't have enough damage. Ame is dead. The curse is broken.
They bring RTZ down once. Can they do it a second time, though? Unlikely. He's put to sleep momentarily, RTZ.
They also pop the glyph. He does not have a BKB, but they can start going in. They need to try to save him. RTZ will actually drop.
Oh, or will he? He's still a... okay, he will. All right, I mean,
they didn't get the barracks.
They didn't get the barracks?
No, I was just...
oh, they didn't.
I
they didn't get the
up,
barracks.
Like, you know, they're keeping things interesting.
He's going to press it. Oh, here we go, Ame. Oh, what's he doing? He's out and he's in. He's over to the side. BKB's up with the supernova's down.
Another
he's got a rupture. Run, but he's been ruptured.
He has no HP, Ame. No satanic.
He's bleeding down low. He's going to stand his ground with the Darbo. Comes in with a zip on the back. He's found him with the vortex. Ame getting low. Can he turn? He's still holding. That's Ame, dead for 2 minutes, but RTZ, he'll fall in return. The buyback's coming out, but there's no buyback available from RTZ. Zip forward, Ame with a three-man vortex, drags them in. Buyback is available,
Ame,
but
Ame
brings nothing to say. Low BKB's out, but nothing to say. Will fall, Ame, in onto the high ground, over to Fabian. Triple kill for Ame. Roar from Ice. They're moving on to Y. He fought back for this. He'll get taken down. Faith behind the last one left standing as Crit rolls in with the stun over towards the Pango. It's game over as Arbed's done with it all. Ultra kill for the Storm. GG is called. Evil Geniuses are going straight to the grand finals.
Finally, you know, they've made it. They, it might be their major.